Dave Smuss, and I do some bronze sculpture here at Harvest Gold Galleries in Lovell. And this is one of my bronzes called The Gentlest of Giants, and it's a scaled down version of a wolfhound, an Irish wolfhound, which are really big dogs, bigger than greyhounds. And kind of a neat story behind this one. It is a limited edition of 10, but the first one was created as a special commission for a woman who just loves wolfhounds and has had many. And this one's name originally was Cartier. And he was a therapy dog during the 9/11 crisis for the firefighters and the heroes that worked on 9/11. And he had passed away after a few years later, I guess. And she loved him so much that she really wanted to kind of memorialize him. So I came over and met the rest of her dogs and got a lot of pictures of Cartier and comparatively used some of the measurements off of them to kind of work this piece out for her in the pose that she loved to see him in the best, with his arms crossed here and laying down. And it was a really fun piece to do collaborating with her. The great thing about the bronze process is long before you get it in metal, you can do it in clay. And you can bring it and show somebody that you're doing a commission for in the clay. And there's still time to change things. And nobody knows their animal like a pet lover. And so if she sees little things about the eyes or any little thing that she wants to change before it goes to bronze, you can change it while it's still the clay model because it's an additive or subtractive medium. So we got it just the way she wanted it, and then we made the mold out of rubber and plaster. And as I said, with Awakening the Cat, it goes to the foundry after that. They pour a wax positive out of that mold. And you even have to spend time touching up the wax to get it just right. Little bubbles might be in it, little seams where the mold line was. And so the wax gets all touched up and made to look more like the original. And then it goes into a silica slurry to create the ceramic shell. And that goes in a kiln. They fire up the kiln and the wax melts out. That's why they call it the lost wax process. And once the shell hardens and it's got a hollow negative space that looks just like your sculpture, it's time to pour the molten bronze in at 2000 degrees. And it fills the space up, cools off, you chip off the ceramic shell, and you do some metal work on it, weld it together if it's in more than one piece, and then you have to burnish and polish the seams of the metal work with little Dremel tools and grinding tools and things like that, make sure all the textures match the original. And you sandblast it with very fine, almost dusty grit so that it's all uniformly colored, and then you put the patina on with a bunch of different chemicals to get all these nice pretty colors. The wolfhounds, a lot of them are silverish gray, so this patina worked out really nice on that one. And then we made this nice jet mist granite base with one walnut to go with it. And she loved it, but the good thing is, instead of just doing one, she let me do an addition of 10. And when the 10th one is done, we'll break the mold so no more can ever be made. That's it.
Thank you.